Hello, my beautiful Aries friends, and welcome to your March 2020 horoscope, where the first thing I gotta say is happy, happy birthday, Aries. It's just about birthday time for many of you early Aries folks, and we'll get to the other half of you as we get to April, but happy birthday. This is your season. You're getting an annual reset, and I think that this month on the cosmic weather front absolutely supports everything that you've got going on. Now, not only do we have Mars, your ruling energy, in the sign of Capricorn all month long, which basically means this is a work month, but it is a productive work month, and it is a month where you get to do stuff, right? Which is very Aries. You get to do things, you get to take action on things, and it's useful stuff. You're productive, you're building something solid, something sound, something that there is a future in, and I love that for you. Not to mention, even though we're coming into the month in a Mercury retrograde, we're getting out of Mercury retrograde this month as well. Saturn is also going to shift over out of the energy of Capricorn into its next ruling energy of Aquarius, where he is as equally comfortable. So we're going to definitely be very future-minded as this month creeps and crawls along. So let's jump in here, let's take a look at the board, and let's see what's going on for you this month. Right at the beginning of the month on the 4th, we see Mercury, who is still retrograde here. He is retrograde in Pisces, but he's going to back on up and move his retrograde show on the road into the energy of Aquarius. Now, this is going to light up your 11th house space, okay? So Mercury still in retrograde is about looking back. We're looking over, we're taking stock, we're revising, we're reconsidering some things, right? In the 11th house, the 11th house is friends. It's groupings, it's organizations, causes. Remember, in the 11th house, this is very, very social. So even social media or things like that where you are socially connecting with other bodies, other souls, and other voices for some purpose, okay? Now, the 11th house is also long-range hopes, dreams, goals. What do you want for yourself? So as Mercury is retrograde here, first of all, coming out of the energy of Pisces, where Mercury's in fall, he's not in full power over there because he wants to think and have the details, and he doesn't get to have that in Pisces. So when he comes back into the energy of Aquarius, not only are you thinking and rethinking of all of those things, but you're doing it quite quickly, right? Mercury in Aquarius, which is a very electric energy, right? It's thinking, it's hypersensitivity, it's hyper overthinking, but mostly Mercury becomes very expressive again in this area. So don't be surprised at all if you don't find yourself being more social as Mercury, even though he's bringing a retrograde, as he comes back in here. You might find more social things that you're going back to, reconsidering and rethinking. And one of the biggest things I want to tell you, Aries, this is your annual reset. Who is on Team Aries? Are you traveling with people who support you? Are you traveling with people who are helping you and pushing you to grow? Are you traveling with people that still fit your world, right? Because if you were hanging out with a group of friends or you were part of an organization and it's been really good for the last 30 years and you're finding that you don't really feel connected to that anymore, you gotta reevaluate that, and the Mercury retrograde will help you do so, okay? As well, we've got Venus taking her show on the road. She's leaving your sign, too bad, right? But she's moving into the energy of Taurus. So this is going to light up your second house. Now, Venus is sharing some space in Taurus here with Uranus. So this is delicious. First of all, Venus is absolutely comfortable in this energy. She's home. She's in Taurus. This is a domicile place. So she's at full power. What she's got to give is coming to your dinner table or to your money table, since that's what the second house is about. The second house is a house and a space and a place of value. What do you value? Your self-esteem, the way you value yourself, comes from here as well. Your possessions that you have. You know, when you look around your house, Aries, is your furniture in the right place, right? Those are your possessions, and are they placed in a way that feels energetically sound to you? What are you doing with your money? how are you making your money? The second house is how you use your skills and your talents or yourself and you go out in the world and make money. Are you demanding what you are worth in every sense of your value out there? Now, as Venus is down here, she's also going to link up with this Uranian energy. And Uranus down here dancing in your second house has been changing your money, right? It's going to continue to change your money for about the next 7 years. It's going to change your value, which again, don't focus so heavy on money because Aries, you are getting a new identity. You are getting a new esteem for yourself. A lot of that is changing as well. So as Venus comes here and she bunks into and has a collaboration there with this Uranian energy, expect to feel innovative. Expect to have unexpected things happen with your money. New ideas. How can you take something, you know, that you're re-seeing or re-looking at between this retrograde and now you think, oh, I've got an idea how I can use that and make some money with it. Or I can sell these things that I don't need anymore and they have value. Uranus is going to snap you into some long-term success, new ideas around things that have to do with value. And Venus wants the very best for you. She's in full power, so she's going to bring you the very best of what she's got to offer, okay? On the 9th, we've got a full moon happening in the energy of Virgo. Now, this is going to light up your sixth house space. A full moon says we need to end something, acknowledge something. There needs to be an adjustment to kick this area back on course. Now, as we look at it, let's take this back for a minute. Think back for me to your Pisces new moon that we have, which would have been happening over here for you, okay? What are the seeds of intention that you planted here to bring something out of hiding, to have a revelation of some variety? Now at this full moon, because it's in Virgo energy, and Virgo is meticulous, detail-oriented, wants the best health, wants to perfect things so they are their highest good. Now you may be getting a hint of the details that need to happen to make whatever you were trying to manifest come to light, right? You're going to get the step-by-step details because you cannot eat the entire cake at once. You've got to do it a little bit of a bite at a time. That's where we get our detailed steps is here in Virgo. Now, because this is the sixth house, it's also the house, besides of details and routines that we do, the house of health, the house of wellness, the house of your physical body's health, as well as some mental health up here. Aries, you are ruled by the head. What is happening with your head, right? Some of our Aries friends, I do know from comments, have traumatic brain injuries, right? This could be helpful to you in this particular area to see a new course of treatment or to help you in a day-to-day routine. As well, if that's not something you've got going on, what are you saying to yourself? What's the conversation up here? Is it motivated? Are you worrying about things? Are you thinking about things and overthinking about things? This particular full moon's gonna say, let's adjust. Let's course correct here just a little bit so we can put the big things in perspective, and no matter what it is, health, the daily schedule, this project, we can do it one little thing at a time. That is gonna help to move things forward, okay? All right, we have also on the 9th, or the 10th, just depending on where you live, on the 9th, we have got Mercury coming out of retrograde. Thank you very much. We got full force, forward motion of everybody on the table here. But Mercury out of retrograde means that now you can begin to move things forward. Now you can take action, right? In February, we did a lot of gathering of information, gathering of resources, reconsidering what we even want our ideals to look like so that we can take action to align with them, right? And now Mercury's out of retrograde. He's thinking, he's got these ideas, he's communicating, he is ready to move forward. And he is going to want you to break patterns that have made you feel trapped. The 11th house is also about your freedom, right? So Aquarius energy is about your freedom. Now, as we go a couple days down the road, Mercury is direct and he's out of retrograde, but it's time for him to move on and continue his forward motion. So he's going to come down here into the energy of Pisces. The 12th house has been a house of power for you, right? Spirituality, maybe even Aries, seeing things or interacting with things or interacting with ideas that are between the worlds, right? I believe that when Aries comes into the energy of Pisces, we all can kind of feel how very thin that veil is, and we can feel very close to it, close to moving between that very transient world. So as the 12th house continues to be lit with a direct Mercury now, you're going to Have an easier time bringing things from your subconscious or bringing things from your past into your current reality so that you can take action on them. It may be easier for you to pray or to be guided towards forgiveness to those who you've not been able to interact with. Now, on one note though, I do want to say, because this is still very powerful and Mercury is of the mind, it's very easy here as well to go back to these ideas of the blame game or the victim game. So the best you can, stay out of those woods. Try and find where you're stuck at the root of an issue, or you're stuck at the root of your research. Maybe you're just not seeing something from the right angle and you can just adjust, okay? All right, on the 20th, happy birthday, Aries. We've got the sun moving here into the energy of Aries, lighting up your first house. So happy, happy birthday. This is your annual reset. What do you want? Who are you going to be for the next year? This is a month to get busy being. You have permission for action this month, so make sure you are taking it. Now, the other thing that's happening is we're coming into the spring equinox. So this is a big deal for all of us. We're all getting a season change. Aren't you ready to kind of shake off that winter energy and be ready for some spring, or be ready for autumn if you're one of our southern hemisphere friends, right? It's just time to breathe some new air, I think, Aries. So it's beautiful that as your birthday time comes around, you also get to usher in this beautiful spring energy for us, where life begins to happen. And that's the month we've got. Life and actions happening. Now, also on the 20th, before we hustle out of there, we've got this neat connection, this conjunction between Jupiter and Mars. And I really want you to highlight this day, okay? Because Jupiter and Mars coming together in the grounded energy of Capricorn, first of all, Jupiter and Mars together is courage. It's bravery. It's initiation. It's like, let's do this. But grounded in the energy of Capricorn means whatever you're going to do, whatever you're going to take on, whatever you're going to be courageous about putting out there, you are doing it in a grounded, resourceful, practical, long-lasting kind of way. So you're not just throwing it out there. This is something you're going to take some actions moving forward that are about bringing a long-term stability to your life. So this day on the 20th, go for it. Go get it. You've got a full green light with that energy, okay? All right. When we get to the 21st, Saturn moving out of the energy of Capricorn, moving into the energy of Aquarius, where he's going to work. And we're going to see this influence until about July. Then we'll have retrograde, and then he'll be back in December for a 2-year long haul, okay? Now, Saturn is also in traditional astrology a ruler of Aquarius. So before you start thinking he's uncomfortable or anything like that, he's not. He leaves the energy of Capricorn, where in Capricorn, we get to see Saturn be very concrete, right? There's structure, it's very practical, but it's very concrete, very big boundaries, right? When Saturn moves into the energy of Aquarius, he's going to start being as organizing and reorganizing as he always is, always resourceful, but now he's going to do it with some airy qualities. So he's like, oh, what's beyond the boundary that I built here? What can I build over there, right? You know, I think of Saturn as this timekeeping energy who, yes, he's built a Target, and he's like, cool, we have a Target. Ah, there's room over here for a Starbucks, right? He's forward thinking when he gets into the energy of Aquarius. What else can you build on the landscape of your life? And furthermore, who are the groupings? Where are the organizations? Where are the friends that are going to take you there? Because with Saturn here, Saturn is a level up energy. So as he comes to visit Aquarius, he's like, we need to get serious about these friends. We need to get serious about the groups that you're connected to. You need to get serious about the causes that you believe in a very social way as well. If you have not leveled up your technology, Saturn's going to give you the hint that you're going to level up that technology, or you're going to level up your devices, or you're going to see things starting to get pretty tricky. So kind of keep that in mind, okay? As we get to the 24th of the month, we've got, where's the moon run off to? On the 24th of the month, we've got a new moon happening here in the energy of Aries. So I feel like this is your birthday moon. This is your birthday gift from the cosmos. So at the new moon, we're going to plant these seeds of intention, right? What would you like to begin in the energy of Aries in your first house? This is about initiation. This is new projects. This is new ideals. This is one of the best times in this year to begin something new. But you're going to plant those seeds of intention at this dark moon. You don't know exactly how they're going to blossom out, but you do know that it is going to happen, right? Now, another thing I want you to kind of consider with this particular new moon. Aries is very good at strategy and planning as well. They don't always talk about that, but you guys are pretty good at strategy and planning. The thing is you do strategy, plan, go, right? Like there's not a simple flow that happens with that. You're pretty good at that. Now, your other moon this month was also in Virgo. So you do have some details. You do have a little bit of a plan in place here as well. And now it's just going to need your action, right? One of the things you may be wanting to do here, Aries, is you spent February getting your ideals together. We talked about that in the video, right? If you don't know what your ideals are, if you don't know where you're trying to navigate your ship, how are you going to know that you're getting there? How are you going to know that you got there, right? So you may be ready to present us a brand new Aries or an Aries that has new actions because you're building something solid for your future. The other thing I keep in mind is that here, having this Venus and Uranus tangle that's going down here, you may actually be feeling a little bit cute. You're like, oh, I have a different self-esteem. Let me dress myself differently. Let me show a new appearance. Let me redo my branding. Let me update my whatever. But something in your appearance at this particular moon could be changing as well. So it's absolutely a brilliant moon. Now, as we close out and we end this month, we're going to see Mars coming over into the energy of Aquarius as well, meeting up with sturdy Saturn. And these two are going to dance together here in the 11th house for just a minute. Now, Mars being your ruling energy and just being a planet of action, of do things. He's up here in the 11th house, so this is friends. This is social groupings. You could have friends coming into your world. It could be a time where you just find that your social life is getting very different or getting very busy again. But Mars also dancing up here with Saturn, this could bring some conflict to your table. If in your friendships something has been going on, if in your organizations you are having to put a little fight or you're having to be a little bit of aggressive or you're having to fight for what you believe in, this could definitely be an energy that rises to your table for sure. And so what I will tell you is remember to think about what it is that you're fighting for. What are your ideals? Because that will align you with the appropriate information to know what changes and what actions you need to make to level up here, okay? One last thought on Mars moving in here, my friends. Mars moving into Aquarian zone is very, very electric. So I'm going to tell you, take heart and pay attention to things that have to do with anything electrical. If you're doing electrical work in your home or on a property or something like that, make sure your electrical situation is good to go. We would not like to see any fires or anything like that going on, okay? All right, Aries, happy birthday. I think it's going to be a fiesta-like month. I'm very excited for you. I look forward to seeing you in the next video and everything else that's coming this year, okay? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye, Aries.